on the class of design of concrete structure. So I hope you all are safe and doing well. So in the previous class, I have discussed about how to design one-way slab, and in the design of one-way slab, we have seen one problems related to this. So in the problem, a continuous slab is given. So for the continuous slab, code suggests the bending moment and shear force coefficient at the support. With the help of that bending moment and shear force, we have checked the depth of the slab, overall depth of the slab, and after that, with the help of shear force, we have checked whether the slab is safe in shear or not. Or after that, we have checked the same thing for the development length. So today I am going to discuss another problem related to one-way slab, that is for a simply supported slab. So in case of simply supported slab, bending moment is computed by computing the total load, and for a simply supported beam or slab, we know that the maximum bending moment occurs WL square by 8 at the center for a uniformly distributed load. So with the help of that bending moment, we will calculate the value of effective depth, and after that we will calculate the overall depth. With the help of this effective depth, we will check from the deflection criteria that whether we have provided that depth is sufficient or not. And after that, I will discuss the design of two-way slab, and in the design of two-way slab, I will discuss two methods, Rankine-Grashof theory and Marcus method. Let us take one problem related to the simply supported slab. So design a simply supported roof slab for a room 8 meter by 3.5 meter clear in size. If the superimposed load is 5 kN per meter square, use M15 grade of concrete and Fe 415 steel. Slab is supported on wall of size 230 mm thick. So here we have to design a simply supported roof slab having the room dimension 8 meter by 3.5 meter clear in size if the superimposed load is 5 kN per meter square. And for the design of this, we have to use M15 mix and Fe415 grade of steel. Slab is supported on a wall of size 230 mm thick. So since this is a simply supported roof slab, so firstly I have to check the deflection criteria. So for a simply supported roof slab, L by D is equal to 20. So with the help of that, we can compute the effective depth, span by span divided by 20. Span is given 3.5 meter. So 3500 divided by 20. So it is 175 mm. Provide clear cover. Clear cover is equal to 20 mm. And diameter of bar 10 mm. So the overall depth capital D is equal to effective depth plus clear cover plus 5/2. So 175 plus 20 plus 10/2. So it is coming 200 mm. Second step, we have to compute the
इफेक्टिव स्पैन. सेकेंड स्टेप इज इफेक्टिव स्पैन. सो फॉर ए सिंपली सपोर्टेड बीम एल इफेक्टिव इन एक्स डायरेक्शन इज क्लियर स्पैन प्लस डी और क्लियर स्पैन प्लस विड्थ ऑफ द सपोर्ट विच एवर इज लेस. सो इन एक्स डायरेक्शन इट इज 3.5 मीटर प्लस डी 0.175 और 3.5 प्लस विड्थ ऑफ द सपोर्ट इज 230 सो 0.23. सो इट इज कमिंग विच एवर इज लेस. सो इफेक्टिव डायरेक्ट इफेक्टिव लेंथ इन एक्स डायरेक्शन इज 3.675 mm. Similarly, effective span in y direction can be computed at plus 0.175 or at plus 0.23, whichever is less. So, effective span in y direction is coming 8.175 meter. So firstly we have to check whether this slab is one way or two way. So ratio of y divided by x direction 8.175 divided by 3.675, it is coming 2.2, which is greater than 2. So our slab is one way slab. Once we have computed the one-way slab, we have decided the one-way slab. So third step, calculation of load. So load can be computed. Dead load is width into overall depth into unit weight of. For 1 meter, I will design. So 1 into 0.2 into 25. So it is coming 5 kilonewton per meter. Similarly, superimposed load is given. Superimposed load 1 into 5, that is 5 kilonewton per meter. So total load, here floor finishing is not given. Thickness of floor is not given. So total load is 5 plus 5, 10 kilonewton per meter. Factored bending moment can be computed. So factored bending moment MU is 1.5 times W L square by 8. So 1.5 into W is 10 kilonewton per meter and effective length is 3.675 whole square. Here is effective length in x direction divided by 8. So it is coming 25.32 kilonewton meter. So I have to check the effective depth. So effective depth. So we know the effective depth is equal to factored bending moment divided by Q into B. So factored bending moment is 25.32 into 10 to the power 6 divided by Q is 0.138 FCK, 15 into 1000. So it is coming 110.61 mm. So this effective depth required effective depth is 110.61 and we have provided 175 mm. So overall depth is 110.61 plus 20 plus 10 by 2. So it is coming 135.61 mm. So adopt capital D is equal to 150 mm.
Dear student, today I have discussed a simply supported slab, and in this simply supported slab I have started the design. So in the design first step we have checked the deflection criteria, and limit state of serviceability says that for a simply supported slab span by effective depth ratio should be equal to 20. So with the help of that we have computed the effective depth of the slab, and with the help of that we have computed the overall depth by providing the clear cover and reinforcement bar. After that I have checked the effective span. So effective span for a simply supported beam is clear span plus width of the support, or clear span plus effective depth of the support, whichever is less. So with the help of that we have computed the effective span in x direction and y direction, and after that we have checked whether our slab lies in two-way slab or one-way slab. So effective longer ratio of longer span to the shorter span is greater than 2, so it is a one-way slab. After that I have computed the load calculation. So different loading is given, so with the help of that we have computed the total load, and with the help of that load for a simply supported beam, we know that for a simply supported beam having a UDL, so maximum bending moment occurs at the center of the span, and that is WL square by 8. So with the help of that we have computed the factor bending moment, and for the given factor, for the calculated factor bending moment we have computed the effective depth, and after that we have checked whether our required depth is less than provided or not. After that I am going to proceed this design by computing the area of steel. So area of steel is nothing but moment of resistance is equal to 0.87 FYAST into D minus 0.42 XU. So with the help of that we have computed, we will calculate the area of steel, and this area of steel I will check whether it is greater than the minimum area of steel provided in a slab for a Fe415, that is 0.12% of B into D. And after that for a simply supported beam I will compute the shear force at a distance of D from the support, and with the help of that shear force I will compute the nominal shear stress, and I will check whether this nominal shear stress is less than 0.5 times the maximum shear strength of the concrete. And after that in the last part I will check for the development length. So this development length quote suggests it should be less than equal to 1.3 times M1YB plus L0, where M1 is the moment and V is the shear force at a distance B from the support. Area of steel can be computed. Area of steel AST. So we know moment of resistance is 0.87 FY AST into D minus 0.42 XU. And this MU, with the help of XU, we can also written as 0.87 FY AST divided by 0.36 FCK into B. So by putting this value, 25.32 into 10 to the power 6 is equal to 0.87 into 415 into AST, and effective depth is 125 minus 0.42 into 0.87 into 415 into AST divided by 0.36 into FCK is 15 into 1000. So here AST can be computed, it is 659 mm square. This AST is compared with the minimum area of steel. So for Fe415 AST minimum is 0.12% of B into D. So 0.12 divided by 100 into B is 1000 into the overall depth is 150, it is coming 180 mm square. So our AST is greater than minimum area of steel, so it is okay. Spacing can be computed. Spacing is for 10 mm diameter bars, pi by 4 into 10 square divided by 658.3 into 1000. So it is coming 120 mm.
So provide 10 mm bar at the rate of 120 mm center to center. Now another step to check for shear. Check for shear. So firstly I have to compute the shear force. So this is the support and this is the loading. Total load is 10 kilonewton per meter and the span is 3.5, clear span is 3.5 meters. So we know for a simply supported beam, load is WL, support reaction is WL by 2, and the maximum bending moment will occur this one, and the maximum moment is WL square by 8. Similarly, if I draw the shear force diagram, so this is the shear force diagram. This is BMD, SFD shear force diagram, and shear force is WL by 2 plus minus WL by 2. So maximum shear force is WL by 2 at the support. And we know the nominal shear stress, tau V is equal to factored shear force by B into D. And factored shear force VU is equal to 1.5 times WL by 2. So it is coming 1.5 into 10 into 3.5 divided by 2. So the value is 26.25 kilonewton. Similarly, VU at D distance from the support. So if I compute the VU at a distance D from the support, so shear force is WL by 2 minus W into D. So it is coming WL by 2 is 17.5 minus 10 into 0.125, and this is the factors, so 1.5 can be multiplied. Value is 24.375 kilonewton. So the nominal shear stress can be computed with the help of nominal shear stress, tau V is equal to 24.375 into 10 to the power 3 divided by 1000 into 125. It is coming 0.195 newton per mm square. For M15 grade of concrete, maximum shear strength of concrete according to IS 456-2000, as I told you, maximum shear strength of concrete depends only the grade of concrete. So it is 2.43 newton per mm square. So our nominal shear stress should be less than 0.5 tau c max. So 0.5 times tau c max is 0.5 into 2.43. So it is coming 1.21 newton per mm square. So our tau v is less than 1.21 newton per mm square. So it is okay. Similarly, check for development length. Check for development length. So for the development length, our development length should be less than equal to 1.3 M1 by V plus L0. So firstly, we have to compute the development length. So 0.87 FY5 by 4 tau BD. 0.87 into FY is 415, and diameter of the bar is 10 mm. 4 into tau BD is 1.6 from the code, so it is 564.14 mm. M1 can be computed. M1 is 0.87 FY AST D minus 0.42 XU. Zero point eight seven into 415 into AST D minus 0.42 into 0.87 FY AST divided by 0.36 FCK B. And for half length it will be half, and it is also half, and this will also be half. So M1 is coming 14.82 kilonewton meter. So M1 by V is 14.82 into 10 to the power 6 divided by 24.375 into 10 to the power 3. It is coming 608.12 meter. So L0 is maximum. Let us assume L0 is taken as, let us assume 125 mm. So LD must be less than equal to 1.3 M1 by V plus L0. 1.3 into 608.12 plus 125, so it is 195.55. So LD is less than 915.55. Okay, it is also safe in, so safe in bond. Here L0 is, according to IS 456, maximum of D effective depth or 12.5, whichever is less, is taken. So this is the problem we have designed of a simply supported slab, and we have checked various things like design in shear and bond. So dear learners, now I am going to start the design of two-way slab. So for the design of two-way slab, what is two-way slab? So span, longer span to shorter span ratio should be less than equal to 2. So a two-way slab is supported on all four sides and support may be simply support, continuous or fixed support, but supported on all four sides. Beam is also a support. And the second condition, the span ratio, that is longer span Ly by Lx should be less than equal to 2. This is the necessary condition. This must be fulfilled, then our slab will be two-way slab, where Ly is the longer span and Lx is the shorter span. These slabs are not two-way slab. So what is the condition for the two-way slab? If I draw a plan view, this is the beam, not a slab, cantilever. Similarly, if two supports are fixed, two sides, but two sides are free. Two side supported slab, but this is not two way slab. Three side supported slab if I draw. So this is the three side supported slab. Three side supported slab, but this is not the two-way slab. So in the design of two-way slab, there are two very famous methods of design. The first one is Rankine Grashof theory, and the second one is Marcus method. So these two methods are very important for the design of two-way slab. So firstly I will discuss Rankine Grashof theory, and after that I will discuss Marcus method, but these two methods will be discussed in the subsequent classes. So let us start about the Rankine Grashof theory. So if this is the span, this is the shorter span, LX, shorter span, LY, the longer span, and this W, so in this direction is WY, and in this direction WX and WX. So the load is distributed in two direction, that is in y direction and x direction. So what is the significance of this x and y direction, and what is the relation between WX and WY? So we can derive deflection is same at any point in two direction. Means deflection in x direction must be equal to the deflection in y direction. And for a simply supported beam having the UDL, so the deflection is, maximum deflection is 5 by 384 EI WX into LX4, and same deflection 5 by 384 EI WY into LY4. So here WX into LX4 is equal to WY into LY4. So WX is nothing but LY by LX4 into WY. Similarly, or WX can be written as, let us assume the ratio larger span to shorter span is R. So R4 into WY, where R is equal to span ratio, longer span by shorter span. So total load W is equal to WX plus WY. So WX can be written as WY into R4 plus WY. So if I take common WY, so it is 1 plus R4. Means load in y direction is W by 1 plus R4. Similarly, Wx is equal to R4 divided by 1 plus R4 into W. Because Wx is equal to R4 into Wy, and Wy is 1 by 1 plus R4. So these are the load calculation in x and y direction. So with the help of this load, we can compute the moment. So moment in x direction. So mx is equal to Wx into Lx square by 8. And Wx we have computed R by 1 plus R4 into W into Lx square by 8. Similarly, moment in y direction is Wy into Ly square by 8. And Wy is 1 by 1 plus R4 into small w Ly square by 8. So these are the moment in x and y direction. With the help of this moment, we can compute the effective depth. Rest of the procedure is same as a one-way slab. So let us take one example. With the help of that example, we can easily understand. So let us assume this is the dimension of slab is given. This is 6 meter, this one is 4 meter, and total load is 20 kilonewton per meter square. So firstly, I have to check whether span ratio, so Ly by Lx. So 6 by 4, it is coming 1.5, and it is less than 2, so 2-way slab. So load in x direction is R4 by 1 plus R4 into W. So R is 1.5. So 1.54 plus 1 plus 1.5 to the 4 into load is 20. So load is coming 16.7 kilonewton per meter square. Similarly, load in y direction is 1 by 1 plus R4 into total load. So 1 by 1 plus 1.5 to the 4 into 20. So it is coming 3.3 kilonewton per meter square. So moment can be computed in x and y direction. Moment in x direction is Wx into Lx square by 8, and Wx I have computed 16.7 into Lx is 4 square divided by 8, so it is coming 33.4 kilonewton meter. And similarly, moment in y direction is Wy into Ly square by 8, so 3.3 into 6 square by 8, so it is 14.85 kilonewton meter. With the help of this moment, we can compute the value of area of steel and effective depth. All the things I will discuss in the next class. So after that, I will discuss in the next class, that is Marcus method.
Dear students, today I have discussed about one problem related to the simply supported slab. And after that, I have discussed the two-way slab. And in the two-way slab, I told you that if the our span ratio, longer span to the shorter span ratio, is less than equal to 2, then our slab falls in the two-way slab. In the design of two-way slab, I told you there are two very famous methods. That is, one is Rankine-Grashof theory, and the second one is Marcus method. Into out of two, I have one method I have discussed, that is Rankine-Grashof theory. So according to Rankine-Grashof theory, they have given the expression to compute the load in two direction, that is longer span direction and shorter span direction. And in two direction, that is x and y direction, they have given the expression to compute the load, that is Wx is equal to R4 by 1 plus R4 into W. And similarly, in y direction, 1 by 1 plus R4 into W, where R is the ratio of longer span to the shorter span. And with the help of this load, moment can be computed in x and y direction, that is Wx Lx square by 8 and Wy into Ly square by 8. So in the subsequent class, I will discuss what is Marcus method, and after that, I will discuss problems related to these two methods. So take care of your health and happy learning.